The BBST course model has been developed over the last several years. It's helpful to understand why the various components are included in the course and how they fit together. This presentation gives you that information so you can share it with students as appropriate. Although we have plenty of ideas on how to flexibly adopt the materials in a variety of settings, this course focuses on the online course model. It's a 4-week model that uses content Chem has been polishing for years for detailed examples, video lectures, orientation exercises, in-class activities, peer review, extensive discussion, and real assessment for the students. Notice that the course has both formal and informal aspects. In face-to-face classes, the informal aspects of courses will naturally develop, but for an online course, it's important instructors provide space for that to happen. In this model, we have put a specific structure in place to help students participate in ways we believe will be productive. In this model, most of the introduction to new content occurs in weeks 1 and 2. Students complete a group project applying their new knowledge and skills during week 3. They study for their final exam during the beginning of week 4 and take it at the end. After the course ends, students complete a course evaluation. Let's take a closer look at some of these elements. As in face-to-face classes, there are instructional and social components. In face-to-face classes, instructors frequently ignore the social aspects of the course and social needs of the students. In most cases, the students informally build relationships and a social structure to complement the more formal aspects of the course. In online classes, the social structure develops more haphazardly, and savvy online instructors usually build social opportunities into their courses, and with good reason. Students who are connected to each other are more likely to complete the course. In the online courses, we typically give students 2 social spaces. The meet and greet forum is where students introduce themselves to each other and begin to form friendships based on common interests. This is a very active forum for the first week and should taper off as students focus their attention on the content of the course. Sometimes we have to remind students to pay less attention to the meet and greet and more attention to the course in subsequent weeks. The hallway hangout is where students share the news they might share if they saw each other on campus. It's a great place for students to share something that's on their minds but that isn't directly relevant to the class. Anecdotes, success stories, hobbies. If students think their classroom colleagues might be interested in something, this is the place for sharing. There are individual activities and group activities. The group project is intended to provide an authentic task, giving students an opportunity to apply what they have learned in lectures, readings, and exercises. In the AST courses, groups typically include people from several different time zones, giving students experience in managing the challenges of operating in a multinational work team. Be sure to check your instructor's manual for more ideas about how to assign students to a group. In traditional face-to-face courses, students regularly congregate in hallways and at vending machines to talk about their courses, their progress in their courses, and their thoughts about quizzes, exams, and assignments. In many cases, they form informal groups to study together. In online courses, instructors can build these opportunities into the courses as we have done in the AST 4-week model. The Help Discussion Forum gives students a place to ask for clarification on an assignment or seek technical support from their instructor or their peers. As an instructor, you should monitor this forum each day. Often, problems raised in this forum prevent students from working on other aspects of the course. The sooner you, or one of the students, can resolve a problem, the sooner the student in trouble can focus on learning course materials. Encourage students to route as many of their questions to this forum as possible. This public space becomes the first place students check for solutions to problems they encounter instead of a private email to their instructors. The Quiz Discussion Forum fosters discussion about quiz questions and challenges in a low-stakes environment where the focus is on fixing misunderstandings and exploring alternative perspectives. Finally, the Exam Cram Forum helps students prepare and discuss course content with the goal of preparing for exams. And, somewhat unique to professional development, the BBST courses have extensive assessment activities that give participants lots of opportunity to practice and apply their skills. We recommend using the quizzes as open book, open lecture quizzes. In Caner's University classes, quizzes count very little toward the final grade. In our professional development courses, quiz grades don't count at all. The quizzes are intended to highlight the important aspects of the lecture materials, the key concepts and definitions, and to help students monitor their own understanding of the lectures by raising a gentle alarm when a student watches a video or reads a text without understanding. No matter the format, AST 4-week model or traditional university model, Caner provides a pool of potential exam questions at the beginning of a course. There are several reasons to provide advanced study guides for exam questions. The practice allows instructors to require better organized and more thoughtful answers than surprise tests where students see a question for the first time. Providing an advanced study guide fosters strategic preparation and deeper learning as students discuss and debate possible answers. Study guides also benefit limited English proficiency students who are disadvantaged by surprise tests as they try to craft answers in a second, third, or fourth language. The cooperative learning tasks of a study group can also help these students improve their language skills. For university courses, the study guide contains no more than 100 questions that will be used for midterm and final exams. For shorter courses, the study guide is proportionally smaller. Throughout the course, students are encouraged to prepare potential exam question answers together and assess each other's work. In face-to-face classes, study groups sometimes form to meet outside of class. In traditional university classes, Kaner has students write midterm and final exams as an individual and grades the answers with the awareness that students had advanced knowledge of the questions. Their grade on the final exam is an important contribution to their final grade. In the online courses, we provide an exam cram forum to replace face-to-face group meetings. The study group forums close during the period students individually write their final exam. The exam is closed book. Once this exam period is over, instructors review the exam and use student performance on the exam tasks to help them determine whether a student has earned a grade of pass or fail. Commercial trainers rarely use study guide questions and final exams in their courses. However, we know that in-house testing professionals sometimes use questions from the study guide when they interview candidates. BBST courses require participants to give extensive feedback so we can determine what we need to change, what we need to tweak, and what we should keep. Industry smile sheets and university course evaluations rarely capture the detailed feedback course designers need to improve their courses. Early drafts of the BBST commercial course were extensively peer-reviewed. More recently, the academic and AST versions of the course have been evaluated using an instrument that allows us to capture detailed student feedback about how individual course components contribute to student learning. The heart of the model, we think, is the cycle of preparation, lecture, and application that you see here. This is the instructional unit that delivers course content. In traditional courses, the course textbook and lecture have been the primary sources of course content. The BBST course materials use a combination of videotaped lectures, course readings, and open book quizzes to form an instructional unit on a specific topic, like domain testing. Lectures are used to convey basic knowledge. A speaker's examples and stories illustrate the complexity of the topics being presented and offer useful illustrations about how the ideas and techniques presented in the lecture are applied in industry. Told well, stories offer a human interest element that make them more motivating and memorable. The videotaped lectures in the BBST materials seek to do that. Videotaped lectures have the additional advantage that students can replay them as necessary. This is especially helpful for those whose first language is not English. We have also gotten feedback that students like to speed listen to the lectures. Surprisingly, there's some research suggesting they might comprehend material better at the faster speed. Course readings present examples and case studies that are relevant to the course content. When possible and practical, course readings provide competing views on a particular topic to introduce students to the variety of perspectives in the field and to illustrate how approaches vary depending on context. We urge you to embrace and acknowledge the diversity of opinions in the testing field and to encourage your students to engage with them critically. We use the quizzes and deadlines to motivate our participants to push hard to keep pace with the class. The quizzes are learning tools to focus students' attention on key elements of the lecture, to give practice with close and careful reading, an important skill for software testing, and discussion starters on points that remain confusing. The truth of the matter is that the quizzes count very little toward a complete, incomplete decision at the end of the course. We care much less about quiz scores than we do about learning from the quizzes. The online courses provide a discussion forum for students to talk about quiz questions and answers to build a deeper understanding of course materials. In face-to-face classes, this kind of discussion may occur in a classroom or between students in hallways. Offering the discussion forum is an important strategy to make space for this type of discussion among online students. In the ideal case, instructors will design a preparatory exercise that focuses on particularly challenging aspects of the new topic. This gives students a chance to confront the challenges inherent in the topic, better preparing them for the new material presented in the lectures and readings. After instruction, students return to the original task with new insights, new skills, and hopefully new appreciation for the goals of the exercises and the content of the lectures and readings. Practically speaking, time constraints will prohibit instructors from using preparatory exercises for each instructional unit, you will almost certainly need to limit your use of preparatory exercises to new topics and the most challenging content, and you will examine why this works so well more closely in another module. In the 4-week AST model, instructors will use one or two instructional units with full iterations of the preparation, instruction, reflection cycle, and several more instructional units that do not have associated preparatory exercises. In university classes that follow a traditional calendar, there will be time for many such iterations. Commercial training formats vary widely, and the number of instructional units presented in a course will vary widely as well.